Thank you. Hello and welcome, everyone. Welcome to Swinging Into the Past and Night at the Savoy, a Project Connect fundraiser. This program is made possible in part by the Queens Council of the Arts with public funds from the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs in partnership with the City Council. My name is Odysseus Bailer, a longtime member of Project Connect and your MC for the events. Today, we want to tell you about our new Lindy Hop show for children, Swing Into the Past and Night at the Savoy. You will get a sneak peek of the show, which includes exciting dance performances. We will also get a chance to meet the main cast of the show and have a live Q&A. At the end of the program, we will be dancing a historic line dance routine called the Shim Sham. It will be taught by our dancers, and we would love it if you all would participate with us. Also, you will find out how you can be part of the show, Swing Into the Past and Night at the Savoy by Project Connect. So please stay tuned for more information. We are also currently hosting a silent auction and raffle to raise money for the production of Swing Into the Past. If you haven't, please go over to the auction site now to check out all the amazing fund prizes donated by our generous supporters. You have various music lessons, arts and crafts activities, makeup sessions, clothing items, and many more. Please visit the link on the screen or the chat. Your support will help us bring our dance-based educational experience to more New York City children in the next year, and we would greatly appreciate your support. For those of you who are new to Project Connect, we are a charitable dance group of professional and amateur dancers based in New York City. Project Connect brings original interactive swing dance productions to underserved communities. We performed in 2017 when we worked on our first production, and during the following 2 years, we've performed at 5 nursing homes in 3 boroughs of New York City, as well as prominent arts organizations including Flushing Town Hall, Brooklyn Public Library, and Jamaica Center for Arts and Learning. The first project was created based on our belief that Lindy Hop, the original swing dance created by the African-American community in Harlem in the late 1920s and early 30s, can bring joy and empowerment through celebrating individual expression and bringing people together. In order for the audience to truly experience the magic of Lindy Hop, our show was interactive, inviting the audience to participate. Before our dance numbers, the audience learned how to sing and dance along with us, as you can see here in the show we did at the Brooklyn Library. To provide a fuller historical experience, we included a vintage fashion show directed by Joy Grad, where we asked some of the senior members to model vintage clothing. The fashion show was always the highlight of the event. Over 50 volunteers have participated in this project, and everyone had a unique contribution to the show. Throughout our process of creation and presentation, we wanted to cultivate the culture of diversity, inclusivity, and creative collaboration within the swing dance community. Each volunteer brought their unique skills and creativity to make the show a magical one. And we would also like to take this moment to acknowledge You Should Be Dancing Studios at www.youshouldbedancing.nyc for generously providing countless hours of rehearsal space for Project Connect. Thank you, Tammy and Charlie. And most of all, thank you for providing us a place for all of New York City to dance, take lessons, showcase new routines, and to listen to live jazz music. Their studio has been one of the true staples of the New York City swing dance community. Now, we would like to share a video created by one of our volunteers, Sego Yokomini, a professional filmmaker that demonstrates what Project Connect is all about.
When they hear the music from their time and they see the dancing they used to do or they knew somebody who did it, it's like they come alive.
Project Connect is a project that brings people together through dance and music. For me, swing dancing is very special. It brings such a joy, and It let you forget about everything and allowed you to be yourself. It gave me some opportunity to have a wonderful time, and I'm sure it can do that to many, many other people.
The energy of the dancers and the professional way they put their routines together, and this following a storyline, and all of it was just such a gift.
Oh, also we had a fashion show. It's a vintage fashion show. We asked four seniors to be a model. We met them and we talked about what kind of clothes they like. We took the measurement. They wore all the vintage clothes on the day of the show.
Sunday afternoon and offer such a gift of their dance to the elders who live here, it really touches my heart, and I know how it's being received. I know that there are people here who on a daily basis, you know, have a hard time being present, you know, and you really have to be there with them to kind of get them to be with us and to have some joy.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Wonderful. Oh, spectacular, spectacular. Well, I'm just happy my daughters got here to see me.
How nice and amazing is that? It has been wonderful to be a part of this show. You too can also participate in our show as a volunteer dancer or as a technical staff. If interested, please visit our website at www.danceprojectconnect.com. Go to the Join the Team page and fill out the volunteer sign-up sheet, and we will be in touch with you. Now, it is my honor to introduce to you all the brains behind the project, the founder of Project Connect, and the caringest person. Yes, that is officially a word now because I said it. The caringest person you will ever meet, Akimi Kinikawa. And she is here to tell you all in more details about our exciting new show. Take it away, Akimi.
Hello. Hello, everybody. My name is Akimi Kinikawa. I am the founder of the show. Thank you so much for joining us today. Today, we want to introduce our new show. It's the another interactive swing dance show, but for children this time, called Swing Into the Past, A Night at the Savoy. Swinging to the Past showcase the authentic Lindy Hop while educating young audience about its history, about history and the cultural context of the dance. Lindy Hop has been an amazing gift to me. I am an immigrant from Japan. I didn't speak English too well. I didn't have many friends. And I felt like I didn't have a clear community that I belonged to. That's when I encountered Lindy Hop, and I was welcomed into the swing dance community in Washington, D.C. With the dance, I felt fearless to express myself and to be myself. And my life changed. So I'm very passionate and committed about sharing this dance and my experience. And also, I'm committed to continue to learn the history and honor and remember where this dance came from. But my experience is not a unique one. I know that many of my friends had similar experience with the dance. And I did start to wonder why this dance has such an amazing, inspiring, empowering energy or even force with it. And as I understood more about the context in which this dance was created and developed, it made a profound sense to me. I learned that smooth dancing and jazz music was born at the end of Harlem Renaissance era, when the Black American artists finally had a safe space to reflect and express their experience collectively. And so the brilliance of this dance reflects the joy of expression or joy of freedom. I understood that to be joyful despite the oppression was their defiance. And I also understood that Lindy Hop is not about rules or restrictions. It's about individual voice through improvisation. I also understood that Lindy Hop is about community and inclusivity. The generations of Black American dance community have always welcomed everyone since the very beginning, despite the fact that this community was marginalized. And the Savoy Ballroom, the place this show will occur, the story will occur, the mecca of swing dancing, was believed to be the only integrated ballroom around that time, welcoming everybody across racial lines and including LGBT dancers. So with this show, we really wanted to include all the core values of Lindy Hop. So we drew upon the defiance, joy of defiance, humor, the inclusivity.
Okay, so just bear with us for a second. We have a little bit of technical difficulty, but I'm going to kind of take it over here and just kind of finish what Kimmy, you know, had in her statement. She also wanted to point out that the story and the dialogue of this performance was written by Veronica Wong, a professional writer and also a Lindy Hop dancer herself. And she wanted to reflect so much of the elements, including the historical and cultural context of this dance. In terms of dancing, the audience will see all types of Lindy Hop, from improvised social dancing to high intensity choreography Lindy Hop. The main parts of the choreography will consist of moves commonly danced on the social dance floor and will be performed by Lindy Hop dancers. Kimmy, along with myself and everyone who has been part of the show, is grateful for this amazing opportunities. Kimmy is also grateful for the six amazing dancers and the skilled dancers, as well as the actors who agreed to be part of this collaboration with Project Connect for this show. And due to COVID, we did keep it very safe as much as possible, given the circumstances to prepare for this presentation. Have at times been extremely challenging, as everyone knows, during COVID. As far as getting together for rehearsal, we had to make sure everyone was, vaccinated and immunized, and even still a lot of the practices were done outdoors until we all felt safe enough to be indoors around each other during the COVID. So with that being said, hold on, maybe we might have a Kimmy back with us.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Kimmy. Can you hear me?
Hello, hello.
Yes, I can hear you, Kimmy. Can you hear me? Okay, so I think we still might be having some technical difficulties. So Kimmy just wanted to say how extremely grateful she is for all the caring energy, once again, for the collaboration put into the show. And this show is a work of progress, and your support will allow us to continue our journey. And we want to thank each and every one of you in advance for all of your support. So with that being said, Hopefully, maybe we can get a Kimmy back on here, but if not, that's completely okay. She will be back later on in the program to speak with us. But with that being said, we are going to continue with the program, and we're going to start off with a nice sneak preview of the show. All right. Let's paint the picture, shall we? The plot follows two siblings who time travel to the Savoy Ballroom in 1939. Through the children's eyes, the audience experiences the magnificent Savoy Ballroom firsthand, witnessing real events at the Savoy and learning about the dance and the music. The children play Cupid, bringing their grandfather and grandmother to be together. Unfortunately, the happiness is abruptly ended by a police raid, like the ones that eventually led to the Savoy's temporary close in 1943 due to the movement against racial segregation. First, you will see the opening scene of the show, followed by the opening dance number to 5 o'clock whistle by Count Basie and his orchestra. Then you will see a dance number performed by our dancers towards the end of the show to the historic film Jammin' the Blues. Our amazing dancers use their wonderful and creative imagination to paint and create a vibrant atmosphere of the Savoy Ballroom. But as amazing as these dancers are, we also need you to help paint and create the vibrant atmosphere of the Savoy Ballroom as well. An atmosphere of live music, energetic and creative dancing, and most importantly, an atmosphere that was inclusive to people of all skin color, orientation, and background.
Okay, Mom. We'll be careful, we promise. I know. We'll come back down in 10 minutes because Grandpa will be here soon. Whoa, careful. Mom will kill us if we ruin any of this stuff. She says it's vintage.
What's vintage?
I think it's what adults call old things that they don't want to get rid of. Remember, we're looking for Grandpa and Grandma's swing dance stuff.
What's swing dance stuff?
Type of hats, Charleston shoes and stuff.
What's Charleston?
I don't know, a type of suit? Grandpa and Grandma would always talk about how much they love the Charleston. I always thought it was some type of car. But Mom says it's all up here in a box labeled...
Swing dance stuff?
Yeah.
Wow, look at this cool looking shoe. I think it fits me. Where's the other one? What's a Savoy?
Wasn't it a place? Grandpa and Grandma were always talking about some ballroom.
This Harvest Moon Ball sounds pretty cool. Wow, it sounds like it was a big dance contest that happens every year at Madison Square Garden.
What are you reading?
A letter. Looks like it's from Grandpa to Grandma.
Let's see it.
No, I was looking at it.
Give it.
No! My dear Claire, I am writing quickly as I have very little time before we move out again. I'm thinking fondly of that night when we met. I had reluctantly joined Dorothea and Clark at the Savoy. That night set us on what I know will be a long lifetime together. Hey!
I remember the green dress that you wore, the sparkling lights, crowded with dancers wearing their Sunday best. Their movement made the dance floor pulse with joy. I can almost hear Chick Webb and Count Basie, their bands both trying to best each other.
It's signed by Charles. Isn't that Grandpa's name?
And it's addressed to Claire. That must be Grandma.
You think this is Grandma's shoe?
Maybe.
Grandma had small feet. Let's see what else is there in those boxes all the way in the back. Look, William.
Just need some pants to match this. Here we go.
think, William?
What are you doing?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? Stop, you look ridiculous.
I can't stop. What's happening to us?
I can't see anything. Can you see anything?
No, I don't see anything, but I feel like thousands of eyeballs are staring at me. I don't see anything, but I hear music. Where is it coming from? It's coming from upstairs.
Welcome to the Savoy, home of the happy feet. Tonight is a special night. It is ladies' night, which means before 8 p.m., ladies get in for free, gentlemen pay 65 cents. After 8 p.m., it's 85 cents for a night of fun. Everybody is welcome as long as you're dressed for the occasion. So, before you head on upstairs for a night of fun and dancing, please have your tickets out and ready.
Harlem in the late 1920s to the sound of big band jazz music. And it's the swinginest music there is, I say.
Sure.
sure is. It's a new American dance that we African Americans in here in Harlem practice every day with new moves and new styles.
Well, my mama always tells me it comes straight from all the African American dances from the past. The ones that she would dance as a child and her mother would dance. You can see all those influences, my mama would say, like tap, jazz, Texas Tommy, breakaway, cakewalk, and Charleston. Dances that live and breathe on people dancing them. You know, like dancing at home, in the neighborhoods, or at get-togethers. Not just in a classroom or on stages. That's why Lindy Hop tells the story of the generations of African American families. We express our emotion through dance, right? That is why the dance reflects our experience in our everyday life. That is why Lindy Hop tells the collective story of the African American community.
Yes, and these dances have evolved just like our music has. And swing dancing is nothing without the jazz that grew out of the blues and gospel, and a rhythm that lets us feel everything that we feel.
Everyone looks so happy dancing.
Yes, girl, you can't be sad when you're dancing the Lindy Hop. Let's look over here. That's called the swing act. That's just pure joy and energy. Man, when I dance, I express myself in a way that makes me feel that there are no words. I don't have to worry about anything when I dance the Lindy Hop. I can never feel this free outside of the Savoy, outside of Harlem.
Dancers, if you dance yourself into a frenzy, then welcome to the Savoy, the world's finest ballroom home of the happy feet. You just heard our unparalleled house band, Chick Webb and his Savoy band orchestra, along with the lovely, marvelous Ella Fitzgerald performing If Dreams Come True. How did Chick and Ella sound tonight, everybody? How do they sound? Yes, and these guys are going to need it because we have a special presentation for you tonight. We got a challenger for the Chick Webb Band. Now, this band comes from St. Louis with a smooth sound that is St. Louis. You heard them around New York City. You heard them on the radio. But welcome tonight, the one and only Count Basie and his orchestra. Is out there, but you don't have to take my word for it. Let them tell you yourself.
Thank you.
Videos were filmed and edited by Ishmael Fernandez, an amazing professional photographer and a videographer and dancer. The sound effects were created and operated by Yurina Shin, a talented professional musician and dancer. Thank you both for your contribution. Hello, let's have a round of applause for amazing performers. So sorry for the technical problem earlier, but I just wanted to come back and say I am so grateful for all the amazing group of dancers, actors, and then behind the scene technical staff agreed to collaborate on this project. And the circumstances have been really, really difficult because of the pandemic. And so, you know, everybody was working a lot recently to make up the time that we lost last year. So we were overworking, we were exhausted, but yet they put so much energy and care into this project. So I am very, very grateful. And I'm also very proud of everybody who is involved in this project. I have to say that definitely this is a work in progress, and your support will allow us to continue to improve this show and bring it to as many children as possible. I know some of you have already generously donated, and also gave us a lot of emotional support as well, and we are so grateful. Thank you. Thank you so much. Now, without further ado, I would like to introduce all the cast members. I would like to start with the actors. You already met him, but first I want to bring in Odysseus. Hello, Odysseus. Odysseus has been the member of this project from the very beginning when we were like tiny group, about 10 people, and he was MC, and I remember he was interacting with seniors with such warmth and humor, and you made the show really, really magical. So thank you for being with us, and he's a professional actor and blues and swing dance instructor. He also helped us to direct the acting part a little bit. So would you like to say hello?
Hello, everyone.
Okay.
Project Connect has been great to be a part of, and thank you for inviting me onto the project, Akimi. So it's been really great fun working with everyone in the dancing. Thank you.
Thank you, Odysseus. Next up is Taneeka Wilder, if you are here. Hi, Taneeka.
Hi.
Is a Bronx native and a writer for the soul and the spirit. Taneeka dedicates her life to using the power of words to inspire, invoke, and transform personal wounds into healing. Her work has been featured at Sisters Uptown Bookstore, and she also reviewed our script for us. And Taneeka has this wonderful energy every time she's participating. So glad to have you with us. Taneeka, would you like to say hello?
Yes, hello everyone. And thank you so much, Akimi. I was really, really excited to be a part of this project. And I'm really thankful for being a part of this experience. It's like recreating history. So thank you. It was fun.
Okay, and then the last actor is Yesica. Are you here, Yesica? Hi, Yesica. As you saw, everyone, she is the rising star and rising artist and creative in the theater, fashion, and makeup industries. She has also been a featured dancer in various music videos and live stage shows. And you know, she's an amazing actress. Her acting is phenomenal, and she was always professional. So I'm so happy that you joined this cast. Thank you for joining us. Yesica, would you like to say hello?
Hi, everyone. I just want to start off by saying thank you, Kemi, for giving me this opportunity, and Brian, too, for allowing me to be a part of this great cast. And it was fun. It was a very great experience.
Thank you, Yesica. Thank you so much. All right, those are the actors. And now Odysseus will introduce all the dancers. Odysseus.
Yes, thank you, Akimi. So it is my pleasure to introduce you all to the fabulous dancers that you saw on the screen. First person I'd like to introduce, for those of us who have been in the scene for 1,000+ years, remembers this dancer when he was just a pup. Now he is a grown man. It is my pleasure to introduce you to one of our first dancers, Brandon Barker. Brandon has been dancing, since he was born. I mean, he literally popped out dancing people. That's how long he's been dancing. All right, he joined the Lindy Hop family when he was in high school, and now he just graduated from the University of Massachusetts Amherst with a stellar graduation performance, a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Dance with an individual concentration on public policy in the arts. Brandon, please say a few words for everyone.
Okay, give me a thumbs up if you can hear me.
Yes, sir, I can hear
you. Awesome. Amazing. Okay. Always great to see you, Odysseus. And again, thank you so much to Akemi. I've grown so much as a dancer and a person through working with you. It's been a joy working on not just this project, but all the other things that we've worked on together that I've grown and developed through as a person. And I'm excited to kind of let this big event and this big masterpiece that we can, you know, enjoy for a little bit, skyrocket us into another aspect of what I think will be a great time working with you. So thank you to Akemi, thank you to Brian for the structure of putting all of these technical things together. And then, yeah, thank you so much for having me.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Brandon. Well said, well said. Next up is a triple threat of awesomeness. Carmen Carriker is our next dancer, and she is a professional dancer, actress, and educator. She is in the cast of the musical On Kentucky Avenue, Taptastic, and the Sophisticated Ladies at the Cotton Club in Harlem. She also teaches yoga at Crown Soul Yoga, which she founded. You can check her out. You can check out her yoga studios at www.crownsoulyoga.com. Carmen, won't you join us and say a few words for us, please?
Greetings. Thank you guys so much. I'm so excited to be here and excited to be a part of the project. This has been a wonderful experience. I'm just so happy to have this opportunity to share swing dance with the world.
Nice, nice. Yes, it is. It is great to share this dance of music, of jazz and blues music with everyone. Next up is Mr. Vintage Personified, tied along with Dandy Wellington. This next dancer is Mr. Samuel Coleman. He has been the number one dancer of Project Connect since the beginning. He has always been dedicated to Lindy Hop and a virtual figure of the dance community, particularly in Harlem, and performs in literally every Lindy Hop routine known to humans. Besides always looking so stylish and always carrying a huge suitcase with him all over the city, he's always so graciously steps in and lends his amazing wardrobe to his fellow dancers and styles them whenever they don't have a particular costume item. Mr. Coleman, will you say a little word for everybody?
Hello, everyone. I'm just so thrilled to be a part of Project Connect. And it's been a wonderful journey working with Akemi. Any opportunity I get to work with her, I do. She put together a fabulous production her first time around. And I'm really super excited for this production that we're currently working on. So, I just want to thank Akemi and the rest of the Project Connect team. And please, everyone that's watching tonight, please tell your family and friends and hopefully we'll be able to see you soon in person and for you to see our productions in person.
Yes, yes, absolutely. You know, so make sure everybody, you know, this is just me saying this, make sure you're practicing, safety and health safety at all times. So this next dancer helps me feel a little less lonely in the dance scene, because as an avid sports fan, personally myself, go Gators, in the Lindy Hop community, sometimes I feel like I'm the only sports fan in the community. But this next dancer, Mr. Sean Vitale, makes me feel, like I said, a little less alone. Sean comes from an athletics background. The high energy explosive power of the Lindy Hop captivated Sean. The dances of Black American origin compelled Sean to move to Harlem and learn more about the dance, the music, and the culture. As both a dancer and physical therapist, Sean believes that the movement is the answer to many of life ails. Ain't that right, my brother, man? So, Mr. Sean, please come up on here and give us a few words. Thank you.
Hey, everyone. I'm Sean. Thank you for the kind introduction, Odysseus, and Akemi. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of this. I'm really grateful to Project Connect. Just watching that video at the introduction, right, of seeing the effect that Lindy Hop has on people, young and old, generations past and generations yet to be. I can't believe the way that it's shaped my life, and I'm so grateful to be able to carry any sort of message of that kind of power. It feels like a real treasure to be able to share with other people, and I hope that it can impact them in the way that it did me.
Yes, absolutely, and that's what it's really all about, is reaching the younger generation of dancers to follow up behind all of us that are currently in the dance scene. All right, everybody, get ready. Get some stretching going on, because this next dancer has an accomplished rap sheet as wide as the Andromeda Galaxy, which is 260,000 light years across, for those who don't know. Shana Weaver is a professional swing dancer and dances with many professional dance groups. She is a dance instructor, and she is an educator that teaches the history of music and dance and African Black American history. To add to her awesomeness, she is the music teacher at York Early College Academy, and she has also been able to tap into the Speed Force to find more hours in the day because she is working on her master's degree in music education at Columbia University. Yeah, I just said all of that. Yes. Shana, please say a little something for everyone.
I am super flattered, first of all, for the incredible introduction. I'm just going to take you with me everywhere I go now. Like, I have a hype person to introduce me. but I'm super incredibly thankful and grateful to work with Akemi. She's super wonderful. Watching this now on YouTube and almost in tears to see that, you know, the history and the culture is still there, and she's promoting it and everything that's been done for seniors and now for kids. I hope they enjoy it as well. But I'm just extremely grateful to work with everyone, including you, Odysseus. Again, I'm going to have you in my back pocket as my announcer, but thank you so much for everything.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you. And you hit it right on the head. What Kimmy has been able to provide to not just the community, you know, in the direct, but also to the surrounding, just in the New York City community as a whole, with bringing it to so many different people of all different ages and backgrounds. So always a huge applause to Kimmy for bringing this to us. And to round out our talented dancers, I cannot forget the incredible Tawni Michelle, who is another individual that has been dancing since she was literally 2 minutes old. Yeah, 2 minutes old, people. All right. Tawni Michelle has been an active performer on the stage since she was a young girl. She performed in touring companies, a musical theater stage, and operas. She has her bachelor's in classical vocal performance with a minor in dance. For the last few years, she devoted her time to studying Lindy Hop. She performs with the Big Apple Lindy Hoppers and with the Bathtub Jennies. She also teaches Lindy Hop on Wednesdays with Spencer Weisbond. Besides from being an extremely talented dancer, Tawni is also a professional makeup artist that is currently working in the fashion, film, vintage, and bridal industry, working with actors, dancers, and models alike. So Tawni, will you please say a little something for everyone?
Well, thank you for that marvelous introduction. So good. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I just want to say hello to everybody and thank you so much for joining. I am so excited to be a part of Project Connect again. I've been with Project Connect for 3 or 4 years and I've got to see different casts. And I got to see different how the show's evolved. And now that our focus is on bringing this amazing show to all of the children of New York City, it's just so overwhelming and excited to dance with such a great group. And we can all make this happen with all of you for supporting us and being with us on this journey. So thank you.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you. And beautifully well said, beautifully well said. And Tawni is absolutely correct. Like, we really can't do this without all of your help. You guys help us make this run. And we always love accepting volunteers, you know, throughout the years for this project. That's what really makes it such a strong family bond. Thank you, Tawni, for that.
Thank you.
So at this time, we would love for everyone to give a round of applause to all of our performers, actors, and dancers. Also at this time, we would love to engage with you, the audience members at home. So please feel free to utilize the chat function to give shout outs for any particular cast members, and also to ask questions to find out more about where our dancers teach, perform, or just their dance experience or experiences in general. So next up, we are going to move to our silent auction and raffle promotion. So while we are waiting for questions from the audience, I would like to tell you about our silent auction and raffle prizes. You have 3 ways to, you know, contribute. 1, by making a general donation. 2, by bidding for our silent auction. Or 3, by purchasing raffle tickets, which cost $5 to do so. Now, Akimi will show you how it's all done. Take it away, Akimi.
For donation, please go to biddingall.com right here. You can go to featured auctions and type in Project Connect and search. Then you'll find our page. You click on that, it will take you to the beautiful homepage created by Phyllis. Thank you, Phyllis. Scroll down, you'll see the donate button, and this will take you to PayPal. Now you can go to this view items, click on all items, and then it will take you to the page that lists all the amazing prizes for a silent auction. And then you can click any of the items. You'll see more details about how you can bid. If you'd like to see the items for raffle tickets, you can click any of those items listed under Fund, A Need, and More. I don't know what that means, but when you click on that, you'll see all the items for raffle tickets. You can purchase as many raffle tickets as you'd like so that you can increase your chance of winning one of those amazing prizes. In order for you to actually bid or purchase raffle tickets, you do need to register with this website. So you want to go to the top and then register, click on register, and you'll provide your name, phone number, and address, and you can sign up with this website. Now Odysseus is going to talk about all the wonderful prizes.
Absolutely. Thank you for that, Akemi. Now, drum roll, please. All right, so we're going to start off tonight with our silent auction. First off, we have a beautiful painting called Rock and Roll, donated by the artist himself, Seth Harris. He is an accomplished artist who has done many paintings of dancers throughout the years. Seth is an exhibitionist artist, member of the Salmagundi Club and the National Arts League. His 8x10 oil painting depicts two rock and roll dancers. The models are lit with the artist's typical Cusco composition. Ah, words, hard sometimes. the woman's bright yellow dress contrasts the dark background. The multiple layers of jewelry on the lead's hand and arm draws your attention in. The facial expressions are reminiscent of those of an athlete in magazine stills. Our next silent auction item we have is a generous donation by Evita Arce and Michael Jagger, who are two internationally renowned Lindy Hop instructors. They are offering an annual membership of Syncopated City. This item includes access to Lindy Hop and solo jazz moves lessons, a technique library, weekly live sessions, guest masterclasses, and so much more. To learn more, please visit www.syncopatedcity.com for more info. Next up, we have a book that is talked about all throughout the swing dancing scene, and it is called Frankie Manning book, Ambassador of Swing, a biography of the legendary dancer himself, Frankie Manning, signed by Frankie Manning himself, as well as the co-author, Cynthia R. Millman. This book was donated by Cynthia and Buddy Steves of the Frankie Manning Foundation. Cynthia also says she will add a customized inscription per request, and this is a not-to-miss item, and this is Frankie Manning, Ambassador of Swing. Next up, this prize is a very unique treat. Have you always wanted to invent your own cocktail, but not sure how to start? Home mixologist Brianna Harris will take your personality, hobbies, and tastes and distill them into your very own signature cocktail. It's you and a glass. For NYC residents, Brianna will deliver your batch signature cocktail and recipe card anywhere in the five boroughs, or prepare your cocktail in person, depending on current local COVID restrictions. Outside of New York City, Brianna will mail you a recipe card and shopping list and give you a virtual class on how to make your unique signature cocktail. Our next auction is also another special treat. One of the greatest things about living in the artistic capital of the Milky Way galaxy, that is New York City, is that we get to hear great bands, great musicians, and amazingly great singers. One of those amazingly great jazz singers is the talented Caitlin Jones. Caitlin is the lead singer of her own jazz band called Kate and the Critters, where you can spot her and her band playing in Central Park and other various spots around New York City. And she is an amazing dancer as well. So if you ever see her, dance with her. Awesome. She has generously donated an hour of vocal lessons for singers of all levels. And she can do this either through Zoom or in person, depending on your personal comfort level. Moving on, our next auction item includes a hip hop private and group lesson by the talented Ray F. Davis. He has been dancing for 14 years. He was the Associate Artistic Director of the Hip Hop Dance Conservatory and Blade Dance Academy. He is also proficient in various styles of hip hop and partner dancing, and he will be joining the cast in future productions. Our next auction is another dear friend of the dance scene. Rafal Postini is a renowned Lindy Hop instructor. He has generously donated a free private and group lesson for 1 hour. You can choose between Lindy Hop, Balboa, or solo jazz for the private or group lesson. Rafal was also a Frankie Manning Foundation ambassador and an instructor at You Should Be Dancing. If you want to learn more, you can email him at www.rafalpostini.com for more information. Rafal is also available to meet up over Zoom or in person, given your personal safety precautions. And lastly, we have makeup service by, once again, our talented dance member, Tawni Michelle. So thank you very much, donors, for the auctions, for everything that you're providing to the community and to the world at large. Thank you. Now we're going to move on to our wonderful raffle prizes. The first in our raffle prize, this generous gift is 1 month membership free for a top level 4 Peter and Naomi dance class at peterandnaomi.com. Donated by the internationally renowned Lindy Hop instructors, Naomi Uyama and Peter Strom. It would provide 1 month of free access to step-by-step Lindy Hop instructional videos, live streams, their online community, and more. Next up in our raffle is a New York City-based international instructor, Bobby White, who has offered 24 episodes, which is 3 complete seasons, of improvisational jazz movement online training videos. It provides 12 hours of practicing inspiration with Bobby. Highly recommend. Bobby is an amazing dancer. Do it. All right. Our other prizes include a trumpet lessons of all levels with Jonathan Kravitz, a face painting session with the amazing Galit Weinfeld. And trust me, you see the pictures right here. She is amazing. Do it. It is awesome. A solo jazz private lesson with Tawni Michelle and a shiny undergarment of Lucky Lindy's donated by Julia Loving. Thank you so much, donors, for providing your services for the community and the world at large. So, wow, that was a lot. I am just like, you know, spitzing over here with all this sweat because it's just so much stuff. But we have already received a number of generous donations from individuals as well as organizers such as the Frankie Manning Foundation. We are also grateful for your support. Your funding will help us bring our dance-based educational experience to more New York City students in the next year and future years. The funding will provide critical support for our core staff, including main cast, technical staff for sound, projection, lighting, costume, rehearsal space, and venue rentals. If you haven't, I encourage you to go over to the auction site right now and check out our amazing prices. The auction and raffle sales end on July 4th at 11 p.m. So once again, you have up until July 4th to bid on these auction and raffle items up until July 4th at 11 p.m. So with that being said, we are going to go into our Q&A. So our first Q&A is going to, be with myself, the dancers, Yesica and Akimi. So if we can get our lovely performers back on here. There they are. Hello, hello, everyone. Hello again. So let's see if we have any questions. Oh, okay. This was so impressive, Akimi. How did you have the idea for this particular storyline? Yeah, go ahead, Akimi.
Hi, that's a wonderful question. Thank you for asking that question. The time traveling always was with me. Whenever I write some fictional things, I always use the time travel, and this was a perfect occasion to use that again. but other than that, you know, I just really wanted children to experience this Lindy Hop that we have, you know, emotionally and physically, and without dancing too much. You know, there are going to be audience, so without dancing too much, I really wanted them to understand what it is. And in order to do that, we have to explain the history, because that's where the power of this dance lies.
So that was my intention, and I'm hoping that it's inspiring enough that maybe children can be more curious about what really happened in the past and continue to think about these things in the future.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, absolutely, absolutely. So yes, our next question is, where can I go swing dancing? So let's have Tawni. Mind answering this question for us? Where can people go swing dancing?
Well, if it's recreational, there are now a lot of outdoor spaces that are doing swing dances on Friday nights. You can do impromptu swing, which is at the front entrance steps of the Museum of Natural History. There's going to be a bunch of Prohibition productions outside on the water. There's going to be a big swing dancing outdoor picnic event next Saturday on the 26th in Central Park. So you can check out New York Swing Dancers group on Facebook or This Week in Swing, and you'll find all of that.
Okay, nice. Thank you. Yes. And yeah, like I said, there's so much more you should be dancing. You know, I've heard through the grapevine that they found a new studio space, but they're still setting it up. So that's also going to be opening up soon for us as well. So yeah, there's a lot of places to go swing dancing. So,
You Should Be Dancing is going to open up in the middle of July with group classes.
Okay. All right. There you go. Middle of July group classes at You Should Be Dancing. Thank you for that, Tawni. So our next question is, what's everyone's favorite song to dance to? I'm going to have Shana, you go ahead and take this for us.
Oh, no. Wow, this is fun to ask me. I'm actually, this is all Latasha Barnes' fault. Say her name and call her out right now because I know she's watching. But she had one day sent me a playlist of Roy Hargrove doing Sing, Sing, Sing. Oh. And I was so amazed. The entire album just blew me away. So I was kind of dancing and creating in my brain all these little dance numbers because the entire album is just so amazing. So go on Spotify and look up Roy Hargrove. It's amazing.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Maybe you can hopefully put that in the chat or something. So in that way we can put it out there for everyone to see. Yes.
Yeah.
That is amazing. I want to stay on this question, and I want to ask Mr. Sean the same question. What is your favorite song or artist?
There's so many great songs to dance to. I'm a huge fan of Naomi and her Handsome Devils, but I'd say my favorite swing song to dance to is Wednesday Night Hop by Andy Kirk. Man, that thing comes out of nowhere. When it builds and it hits, woo, it'll take you by surprise. It's the best.
All right, nice. As for me, what my favorite is Catherine Russell, who is a local jazz singer here. And my favorite song is My Baby Just, oh my gosh, what's her song? Her song is called, hold on people, I got this. As Long As I Live, there you go. Yeah, As Long As I Live by Catherine Russell. That is one of my favorite songs by her, and she has many other songs. And so that would be my go-to artist. So the next question that we're gonna ask is, what do you love most about Lindy Hop? And I want to throw this over to Mr. Brandon Barker. So give us some knowledge. Give us some knowledge right now.
I'll kind of mix in some knowledge and just how I feel. With Lindy, I love the culture of it, the history of it. You know, it's something where you can't know where you're going unless you know where you've been. So, you know, using the past history and the past pioneers, which is a large sector of people who all contributed different styles and different movements and, you know, having the privilege to speak to some of those people and hear some of their, you know, stories of how they made an air step, you know, where their friend was like, go look at that, go get that step that they're doing in the corner, and they would just, yeah, take it and put their own spin on it. Like, mm-hmm. hearing all those stories is just a joy and super fun for me. So I love everything about the culture of it that comes with the history, and just allowing yourself to be informed by, you know, the people that came before you. And it forms you a lot, not just with the dance, but just with life and who you should be as a person, and to not be ignorant and have an open mind. And so it can really teach you a lot if you allow yourself to become opened up to that whole spectrum of everything that history and the people from the history have to offer. So that is most definitely what I'd say I love about it. And I have, of course, my own self-indulgent answers, like, you know, I love adding my own hip hop and, you know, my own style and stuff in there. You know, I can interject with my hip hop house dance Chicago footwork styles with Lindy, and so that's always fun.
Nice. Yes, absolutely. Everything there was beautifully said. I'm going to bounce the same question over to Mr. Samuel Coleman. So, Mr. Samuel Coleman, what do you love most about the Lindy and the Hoppin'?
Wow. I would think probably the most thing that I love about it is how it's intergenerational. So, you know, no matter, you know, how old you are or young, you know, you can share this with anyone, you know. So, you know, I could do this with my dad, you know. I could do this with my mom and my sisters, or, you know, my brothers, you know. So that's one of probably the coolest things that I really like about this dance, that you can just share with anyone. You know, I have other, you know, different styles of dance that I did before I started doing Lindy, but those were things that you really couldn't share with anyone, you know. You know, but this is something that it takes two people, you know, so, you know, there's a specialness to it. So that's what I really like about. And then most of all, it goes with jazz music, you know. So
yes.
just that the marriage of, you know, sharing, you know, the dance with someone, having a partner, and then doing it to jazz, you know, it's just a wonderful thing, you know. So
yeah, absolutely. And Yesica, who's on here, hello Yesica. So for you, like what about you? What is it about jazz music or Lindy Hop or being part of this production has really, you know, like have really connected with you?
Have in mind, I'm only 19 years old. So the first time I heard of Lindy Hop was actually through this production. So that was a very new experience because I've never actually seen the dance. And when I saw all the dancers actually doing the dance, I was like, wow, like this is really a new type of dance that I've never seen before. And it looked so amazing, the way that they were dancing and having a connection with each other. It looked like so much fun.
Yes, it is fun. And we are going to get you out on that dance floor as soon as humanly possible. So, you know, so yeah, so we are going to inundate you with this beautiful music and dance style. If there's not any more questions from the guest watching.
Well, Odysseus, I'm sorry to interrupt you.
Yes.
But I need to make a correction because I said a wrong person. And being a music teacher and a jazz person, I would never forgive myself. But I said Roy Hargrove, and that was a lie. It was Roy Eldridge.
Ah.
So I just want to clear that up. Sing, 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 Roy Eldridge on Spotify. I'm done now. I just need to be done.
Well, thank you very much for that. Thank you very much. All right. So with that being said, we have a very special treat for everyone who are watching tonight. We are going to do a nice little dance that I'm going to let Akimi explain to everyone what we were about to do. So go ahead and take it away, Akimi.
All right. Okay, audience, finally it's time for you to dance Shim Sham, the very historic line dance. originally created for the tap dancers by Leonard Reed and then Lily Bryant. But the famous version in the Lindy Hop community is the one recreated by Frankie Manning, the one and only Frankie Manning, who is one of the original legendary dancers. He recreated in the 1980s without the tap portion. And whenever a certain song comes on, the swing dance community gather and we dance Shim Sham. And it's a nice moment to remember where this dance came from. And also this wonderful routine bring us all together, representing the value of Lindy Hop. So now I am going to welcome back all the dancers and they're gonna show you how to dance Shim Sham. So Sammy, would you please take it away?
All right. Okay, I am going to teach you the
legendary dancers. He recreated in the 1980s without the tap.
Sam, I think it's okay now.
Okay, you can hear me now?
Yes.
Can you hear me? Okay. I'm gonna teach you the stomp walk. So the stomp walk is... And then you can also do it on the other side. Stomp off. Can everyone still see me and hear me?
Yes, Amy.
Yes, all right. So one more step. I'm going to teach you a break. So this one right here is a full break. We're going to go step, touch, step, hop, step, open, close. Step, touch, step, hop, step, open, close. And you'll have an opportunity to do this with some of the other cast members too. So don't sweat it if you don't get it this first time by me showing you, because you'll get to do it again. So you've learned two steps so far. You learned the stomp walk. You can do it on the other side. And a full break. Step, touch, step, hop, step, open, close. All right. Practice.
Teach you the next step. And hi, everybody. I'm going to teach you the next step in the Shim Sham, and it's called crossovers. So just follow along. Super fun, super easy. All right, we're going to start. You're going to push, push. Cross over, push, push, cross over, push, push, cross over, cross over, cross over, hold, step out. Now let's do that one more time, a little bit more to rhythm. Five, six, seven, and you push, and you push, and you cross over, push, push. Cross over, push, push, cross over, cross over, cross over, ba-ba. I can't wait to see you all do it. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. So now that Tawni just taught you the push and crossover, I know you can't see my head, but I like to teach with just my legs because it makes sense. We're going to do the tachyannies, and you did a little cross and you opened up. And all you're gonna do is take little step backs, like back and step, back and step, back and step, back and step. There's a cool little thing if you can get this little rhythm, la do, that'll be nice in between every three. You have back and back and back, step, la do, back and back and back and step, la do, back and back and back and step. And then Sammy was so cool to teach you the break that you're going to do it again. You do step, touch, step, hop, step, open, close. Now we do it together. After you're here, you bring your whichever leg back, back, and back, and back. Step, ba-doop, back, and back, and back. Step, ba-doop, and back, and back, and back. Step, step, touch, step, hop, step, open, close. Now Carmen's gonna show you the rest. Here we go.
All right, I'm going to show you the half break. So you're going to start with a hop, step, kick, change, step, change. Then you're going to do the break, step, touch, step, hop, step, hop, in. All right, and let's do it again. Hop, step, kick, change, hop, step, kick, change. Then the break, step, touch, step, hop, step. Out, in. All right. Take it away.
All right, so the next step that we're gonna learn is the boogie back, followed by a boogie forward. So the boogie back is a little kick ball change, just like Carmen showed us, but we're gonna do it with a little clap. It's gonna look like this. Back, boogie back. Then we're gonna boogie forward. You're gonna use your hips. Boogie forward. Back, boogie back. Boogie back, boogie forward. Three, four. A one time. Yeah. There we go. And Brandon, take it away.
And for your last step of the day, we are going to do something called a shorty George. So how that goes is that, so you've just finished your boogie back, boogie back, boogie back, boogie back, and boogie forward, forward. One more time, go boogie back, 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 and back. And you're gonna kick the leg out just slightly, not a big kick, just out. And then you're gonna lean that knee into the other knee. And they kind of buckle around each other on purpose. So it's gonna be lean and then switch. And now that knee at the back is the knee in the front. Switch, 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 switch. And now you're doing the shorty George. So I'm gonna back up so you can see it again. So small, subtle kick into the lean into one knee, lean into the other knee, and the arms, the fingers can point if you'd like. You can get creative with them, but you'll usually see people do the pointing in the direction of the knees. So kick, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. And let me back up, full body profile. So I like to get creative with my arms. I usually like to like circle them, but let's keep it nice and simple. Just know that you can get creative with arms. So here we go. I'm gonna count you in if you like counts. So, and a 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yay, you're done. Okay, now that is the whole shin chip. So now you know the whole thing.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you. Thank you, dancers. Thank you, dancers. So everyone, Taneeka and Akimi and Yesica, and thank you, dancers and audience. You guys look amazing. You look great. So now we are going to do this to music. Yes. Yes, believe it or not, there is music involved. So what we're going to do is the first section, we're going to repeat this whole entire thing twice. Right, so the first section, we're going to do it all the way through, just as the dancer showed you. But during the second round, we like to throw these things in called freezes into the dances the second time around. But don't worry, Frankie Manning, one of the original Savoy dancers, will tell you when. We will be dancing to Stomping at the Savoy, recorded by the wonderful and also New York local George G and his Make Believe Ballroom Orchestra, with Frankie Manning himself doing the call outs or the shout outs, as we like to call them. We are slowing down the song just a bit so that everyone can enjoy it. All right. Dancers, are you ready? Okay. All right. Everybody else, are you ready? All right. Good. So music, please. And let's do the shim sham.
We're going to have Joy G swinging band playing the shim sham. A one, two, three, four.
All right, that was amazing. Give yourselves a hand. That was awesome. Yes, that was amazing. Thank you, dancers. You are all wonderful. Thank you. Oh, that was good. I need to towel off. Okay, they just got on me a hot over here. Okay, hold up. All right. Okay. Now, unfortunately, it's about the. Oh, I believe a Kimmy would like. She would not like to say anything at the moment. So I believe that it is time for us to unfortunately say goodbye, as all good things must come to an end. So it's time to say goodbye to all of our family.
Thank you.
MICKEYMOUSC. Yes, exactly. For those who aren't a million years old like myself, that's from an old show called The Mickey Mouse Club. But we want to thank you all for joining us tonight and for your wonderful, wonderful support. You don't know how much this all means to us here at Project Connect and for everyone who is involved with Project Connect. This event could not be possible without our volunteers working behind the scenes. We want to give a big, huge thank you to the fundraising team, Phyllis Mung, Kevin Cho, and Galit Weinfeld, as well as our amazing facilitator of our live stream tonight, Brian Lawton. Let's everyone give him a round of applause, a hand, a big huge smile in the chat section. Thank you, Brian Lawton, for coming in and bringing us all together. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We are also grateful for your contributions to the project itself. Once again, we want to thank all the donors for your generous support. We want to also thank Queens Council of the Arts for sponsoring this event. Hope to see you soon. I hope to see everyone at the show. Swing Into the Past, A Night at the Savoy. Please continue to be safe and healthy in whatever you do. And most importantly, good nights and good luck. Thank you.